America's Wild West was an exciting place. But it also has a history of extreme violence. Especially against Native Americans. Some places have seen so much bloodshed, you wonder if the negative energy lives on.
I'm on a mission to see if lands could be cursed.
And hopefully find the evidence to prove it. So we're here in the mountains of California, near an unusual town called Bodfish. A rugged landscape with an ugly past.
It's close to the Keysville Massacre, where 35 natives were slaughtered by the U.S. cavalry.
By the mid-19th century, many tribes were assimilating into American culture, working on the ranches, going to church, peacefully living side by side with the settlers. But in 1863, Captain McLaughlin of the U.S. California Cavalry heard rumblings of an Indian rebellion. Though McLaughlin had no proof, he rode into the valley, captured 35 natives, executed them. Ever since, it's believed their spirits have cursed this land, tormenting the living and holding the dead in limbo. There's so many stories of hauntings over these lands, especially at Silver City Ghost Town, which is where we're headed right now.
Jay, this place is fantastic. Can you tell me a little bit about the history?
You bet. This is Hot Springs Valley. The Indians called it that because everywhere they went, they had the sulfur springs, you know. And it was all really sacred for them. I know the entire valley is haunted. I can't take you 500 feet without showing a place where somebody was buried. These hills are covered with blood, American Indian blood, massacres.
I've heard a lot of stories come out of this place. Some of these structures are haunted.
I'd say every one of them.
Really? So who do you think it's haunted by?
I think there's a number of people who are living there forever because the ghosts usually stay where they're at. I can feel it.
So it's not necessarily the natives haunting the land, it's anyone who's lived on the land since then?
Yeah. The first one that we know was Annie Sullivan Boathouse. She was a pioneer here. She was piss poor. She didn't have two dimes to run together, supposedly. But she somehow bought up every bit of property you can see in every direction, almost.
Wow.
And so I think it's haunted by her. Her energy was very strong. People were scared of her. But the jail is one of the most haunted sites here. It was built probably in the 1870s after the gold rush. The location where it was saved from to bring here was Whiskey Flat, real famous town.
Wild West town, right?
Yes, but absolutely insane. When I go into jail, I always tense up. My body gets really rigid, you know? Many reported being touched on the shoulder or somebody tapping on their, or pulling their hair.
Really?
The church opened in 1929, didn't last that long because of the Great Depression. So it's haunted with people that lost, you know, everything they had. And then the Palisade Berliner House. It's been called the sixth most haunted site in America.
What do you think happened there?
Well, there were 17 children raised by just one man, and that was Francisco. Back then, he had 17 children. You'd be lucky to make three of them each age 18.
Is it true that people have encountered poltergeists in the house?
Right. I think it's the ghost of his children, perhaps one of his three wives.
Did you ever experience anything over at the Romano house?
Absolutely. I had a lot of things. Knocking on the back door. And I witnessed bottles floating, shot glasses getting knocked back. But I went, what the hell?
Jay, I really appreciate you telling me all these stories.
You're welcome. You need anything, let me know.
All right, thank you.
Annie was the matriarch of Silver City, And this house is where she lived and died.
People were scared of her. Her energy was very strong. So I think it's haunted by her.
This is our last structure of the night. And honestly, I'm really hoping to make it out of here without a negative spirit attaching itself to me.
So, let's go. You first. All right, you hold on.
I'm scared.
Okay. All right. This is a good place to set up.
I'm going to start with the REM pod, which will light up green if any foreign energy enters the field.
Okay, so we don't mean any disrespect by being here, but I have a few questions to ask. So if there are any spirits in this room, please approach this device I have at the center of the table.
This person seems ready to talk.
Thank you very much. We appreciate you communicating with us. We've heard stories that you were attacking visitors and pushing people. I'm curious, is it Annie Sullivan? So it keeps happening.
I'm starting to feel like, because of the curse, the land is holding spirits here against their will.
Are you angry that we're here? Are we disturbing your peace? So I guess I'll take that as a yes. Like a big yes. So considering we're disturbing your peace, would you like for us to leave? Okay.
Let's go.
Bye.